Hello and welcome, or welcome back to the Three Strands Pod. What's up, y'all? What's up? What's happening? What's good? What's going on? I hope you guys are good. I hope you guys are feeling strong, even though the sun is basically only up for like 2 hours in the day and then it sets again. I hope you guys aren't feeling too demotivated. How are you guys feeling? Oh my gosh, what are you guys' New Year's resolutions? Come on, if we're gonna make them, we have to be quick. We only got like 2 days left. Okay, I'm joking. Big exaggeration. We got some time, but you know, this corona, time be moving slow but fast, so blink and it's 2021. Are you guys going to the gym? Oh, I say going to the gym. Will the gym even be open? If the gym is open, are you guys gonna go? What are we doing? Are we saving money next year? Are we spending it because there's no guarantees? What are we doing? How are we living next year? Let me know. Any resolutions or no resolutions? What are we saying? If I had to have a New Year's resolution, I would say that mine is to be outdoors more. Yeah. Live a little. Live on the edge a little bit. Live on the edge. Do what I've always wanted to do. So when you go to bed at night, you don't think, oh, damn. I should have. Why didn't I? No, there's no time for that. There's no time for that. Literally, when we had the first lockdown, I was like, oh my gosh, why didn't I do that thing? Or why didn't I go to that place? Or why didn't I experience da-da-da-da-da? Mate, life is so short. And literally, we've seen it. You can plan your whole year and then get trapped in the house for 10 months. You have to really chop this life before life chops you. Because life has chopped us, you know. Oh my, life has chopped us. Dicing us. That's what she was doing. She was chopping. I didn't even chop this year. This year I didn't chop life. Life actually chopped me, but I'm still standing, so I guess I won. But next year we go again and I'm aiming for top two. And I ain't two, so I'm saying. Alright, no more rambling. So, without further ado, let's make it do. Oh, what it do? I don't know why I'm talking like this. Oh my gosh, yo, I'm sorry. Without further ado, make it do. What it do? I said without further ado. Cue the intro. I like energy, ice and Hennessy. I can never be a plus for four. Energy, ice and Hennessy. I can never be a plus for four. With a life like this and a price this big, I can never be a plus for four. All right, I have a question. Do you man believe in judge, voodoo, black magic, witchcraft, them things there? What are you man saying? Are you a believer? You're not a believer? I'm a believer, I couldn't leave her if I tried. Then I saw her face. Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. Do you know there's a song for everything? And I probably know the song for everything. But yeah, what are you man saying? Are you believing in judge and whatever? I ask because I was watching the 90s baby show, which is the best podcast. Now I'm only saying that because, you know, you have to support the black people, but everybody knows that Three Strands Pod is the best podcast, but we'll get into that later. But yeah, the 90s baby show, best podcast ever, honestly. Temi, Fred, VP, they are fantastic. If you don't know, you better get to know, fam. Get to No, they are hilariously sick. Obviously, you have to support the black Brits, support the black brothers. We have to support our people. And they're good. So why not support them? Okay, so on the 90s baby show, the guys, Temi, Fred and VP, were talking about how technology is basically just modern day judge. And when you hear that, you're just like, fam, you're just waffling, like, that makes no sense. But listen, it actually makes sense. A lot of technology is actually judge. Like, how are we able to call someone over the phone? As in iPhone 11, 12, iPhone 6, iPhone 5, 4. There's no wire and there's no lag. I'm calling you and I can hear you responding to me in real time. How? It's Judge. Big man thing is actually Judge. When you actually think about it, all this, these waves in the air, it's Judge. No, big man thing, I believe it's Judge. I'm telling you, it's Judge. FaceTime. You can see a man's face across the world. I can call someone in the US right now, FaceTime. A man will pick up and I can see your face and I can talk to you. No lag. And you're telling me it's not Judge. It's Judge. You know, I know it's Judge. It's Judge. Huh? When you actually deep it. And I think it was Temi that was saying on the podcast that, like, in different parts of Africa where there's like black magic and there's like witchcraft and stuff, they used to have like fires and people would look into the fire and they can see stuff that's happening across the world. That obviously is just plain old Judge. Simple and plain, understandable Judge. Yeah? Now they've basically just repackaged it. I said, oh, the telephone. If you press these numbers, insert the number here and just press call, then you can see a person 93 billion miles away. No lag. Fam, it's Judge. There's Judge inside this phone. I'm telling you, there's Judge inside it. Why do you think it's called Apple? There's sin inside this phone. There's Judge in there too. I'm telling you, big man thing. But I say all of that to say, this episode is about a black history maker in technology who, thanks to him, we can experience the beauty of the Judge of the iPhone, the beauty of the Judge of the Samsung, the beauty of the Judge of the, who else is there? The smaller men, you know, them smaller companies, them man. We can experience the beauty of the Judge of technology. All thanks to Jesse Eugene Russell. So, Mr. Jesse Eugene Russell was a pioneer in cellular and wireless communications. So in 1988, Russell was leading the first team from the Bell Laboratories that actually introduced the digital cellular technology into the United States. And even though at that time, this was 15 years after the first mobile phone call had actually been made, that first call was over an analog system. And Russell's team were actually the people that developed the technology that actually transformed communications. So on his first day at AT&T, which is a telecommunications service provider, he was asking them, like, how come you man are losing so much money? And they said to him, the problem is we can only make money when people are in their cars and the phone rings and they answer it. Most of the time, people aren't in their cars. So obviously Russell was like, that seems like an easy problem to solve. Why don't we just take the phone out of the cars and put it on the people? I guarantee you, when it rings, they'll grab the phone. Every time they grab the phone, we make a dollar. Was he wrong? Nah. Well, obviously now we just have Do Not Disturb, so sometimes we don't even hear it ring. We don't see it and we don't feel bad. Bet you didn't see that coming. So obviously at that time, the phones weren't, I was going to say small, but you know, they're making plus size phones now. So the phones weren't small enough to fit in pockets like they can now. So they figured out the problem was that there were more people than cars and there's not enough spectrum for the amount of people that they had. So Russell suggests that they completely digitize the speech and substantially reduce the amount of bandwidth required on a per user basis to enable them to get 4 times the amount of people on the same amount of spectrum. So from 1984 to 1988, they built the first digital cellular system in the world. In the world. Thanks to the idea, the brain of Jesse Eugene Russell. Black excellence, ladies and gentlemen. Black excellence. And so the use of digital technology was dubbed 2G. This is for second generation of mobile phone systems. And obviously we've had 3G and 4G and now we're even on 5G. And so Russell was actually the vice president of Advanced Communications Technologies. He was vice president of Advanced Wireless Technology Laboratory. and chief wireless architect of AT&T, which I think is fantastic that he had all of these roles and was able to do even more for the development of wireless communications. And so Russell actually patented dozens of innovations within wireless technology, such as the base station tech, which transmits radio wave signals to and from mobile devices. Now, this is the kind of judge I was talking about, because can you see radio wave signals? So how do you know they exist? I ain't buying it. If I can't see it, it don't exist. Therefore, it must be judge. I'm telling you. Don't say I ain't telling you. Don't say I ain't warning you now. And you know what? The greatest part of this whole episode is that Jesse Eugene Russell is alive and kicking today. Only 72 years old. And when I was watching a short clip on YouTube of him explaining like his story, he was talking to kids in, I think it was elementary school. I don't remember if he said what grade they were in, but these were like young children. And when he was telling the kids who he is and what he's done, one of the kids came up to him and was like, "Did you really help to invent the phone?" And he was like, "Yeah." And then I think it was a girl, she was like, "I thought all the black inventors were dead." And I was like, I'm glad she said it, because I ain't want to say it. I sure as hell thought the same thing. But I was like, it was for him to say that, like, he looked quite upset. But obviously, like, this ain't a normal thing for us. That's why it's so fantastic that a man that has literally pioneered the wireless communications industry is alive and well to see. He's done 2G, we've had 3G, 4G, we're up to 5G. He's seen the touchscreen phone way back, like before BlackBerry, before everything. He's seen when the phone was in the car, then the phone was too big to go in the pocket, everything. And he's alive today. I think that's fantastic. He must be proud. I know I would be. That's crazy. Big up Jesse Eugene Russell for that. So the next time you look at your phone, and the next time you want to text your friend, "Hey pal, how are you? Let's go out to dinner." Or you want to FaceTime your friend across the world, thank Jesse Eugene Russell. Because without him, boy, we'd be talking to people through smoke. We'd be doing old school judge. Now we're with the new school judge. Please don't dabble in church, guys. Don't go and involve yourself in witchcraft and black magic. I hope what I've said hasn't enticed you to go and dabble in that. Please don't go and do that. We don't have to. They've repackaged it for us. Now it's just in the iPhone. Okay, I'm gonna stop. But yeah, next time you guys FaceTime your friend from your laptop, from your iPhone, from your iPad, call a friend via the phone, thank Jesse Eugene Russell, because without him we wouldn't have this. Thank you, Mr. Russell. And thank you guys for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you guys learned something new. Check him out. Do a little research into Jesse Eugene Russell. He doesn't even look old. 72 and he looks like a young thing. I shouldn't have said that. Well, I said it, but I'm gonna catch you guys on the flip side. Peace in the Middle East to you and your crew. What? Peace in the Middle East to you and your crew. I like energy, ice and Hennessy. I can never be a plus for four. Energy, ice and Hennessy. I can never be a plus for four. With a life like this and a price this big, I can never be a plus for four.